Really? So does that mean you'll stop telling me to call your dad's friend?
Thank you. Thank you. I'm doing good. There's a storm coming. It's coming around the bend.
Yep.
3:30 in the morning. Not a soul in sight. City's looking like a ghost town on a moonless summer night. Raindrops on the windshield. There's a storm moving in. He's at Maxim's or
lots about
you.
Oh, yeah.
I think my mic's working. Can you not hear me?
I guess I remember not going to college when I was younger, so that I could have lots of stories to annoy my coworkers.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Talk to me.
I actually kind of like the
I think it's working. Should be working.
It makes me feel like I'm on hold all day.
Glenn, you like everything about this store. That's weird, man.
What? I don't like everything about this store.
What? Can't hear you, but it's not as good. Is that better?
Splash in the employees.
I cranked it up higher, I guess. Like I don't know. I didn't change anything. Are we good?
Anything that bugs you about this
store? I didn't change nothing. I don't know why. Superstore? Yes. That's what I'm watching right now, is Superstore. Oh, I wonder if I have the wrong
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's a bummer.
Sturgis and Sons was a community. Customers would be like, hi,
yeah, it should be working properly. In effect, let me see if you can hear it. There we go. Is that better? Can you hear me now?
Okay.
Can you hear me now? Yeah, I have Superstore on. I don't know what the difference is. Yeah, there we go. I have it cranked up. Boom, boom. That doesn't look good, I think. But yes, I do have Superstore playing in the background on Amazon Prime. Any other questions, comments, concerns, let me know. I'm just done with the cables, with the bicep hammers. I'm going to start doing the, doing dumbbells, preacher curl, and standing. Can hear, but sounds like you are speaking in a large room, if that makes sense. I have no idea then. I'm not sure. I don't know. It sounds like echo. Not sure. I'm tech-tarded, so enjoy the tunes. If you have any questions, let me know. But yeah, I'm using the same headset I always use, and there's always a problem. Super, super fun time. Super, super fun time. Like I'm doing closer. Yeah, I don't know. Or also the mic's probably going soon. Like I said, once the summer sale happens, like at Best Buy or whatever, I'm going to be getting a new headset. I'm going to be getting the Corsair Void Pro, which I had before. It was absolutely amazing. It's Bluetooth. That's what I'm getting. Yep. the mic and move it too much. Like it's set. There's like an angle already set on the mic, and I think that I moved it so much that I think the wiring might not be great. So I'm not sure. I'm trying my best, but it seems like there's always. The headset I got originally, I always told it because it was open back so I could hear things going on, but it literally, you cannot hear the music playing. It's ridiculous. They weren't super expensive, so thank God. But if you have any questions, comments, concerns, just let me know. Louder, why? Why? Is it creepy? Not it. Why? No, I don't know. I wasn't really a fan of My Name is Earl, to be fair. And that's kind of literally the exact same type of thing. Recovering alcohol. Yeah, see, I'm not really into the, I don't find humor in disease or in alcoholism. It's like, what's that other one? It's not selfishness. The one where the guy's the alcoholic and his family basically have to take care of him. I don't find humor in that. I don't find humor in people that are down with luck and things just happen to go. I don't find humor in that at all. I know a lot of people do. I just don't find like alcoholism or people down with their luck entertaining. That's just me, I guess. I don't like watching people going through bad times. I don't find that. Well, yeah, it's a comedy, but it's a comedy because they force it to be a comedy. It's a dark comedy based on someone that's down on their luck, which I don't find humorous. There's lots of comedies out there. I might not like it, though. You know what I mean? It depends on what type of humor you enjoy. I don't find humor in disease or people down on their luck, and that's exactly what that is. Shameless is the other movie I was thinking about. So, yeah, I'm not interested in that stuff. I like uplifting positive stuff, not down on your luck. It's going to be a positive thing. Like, no, like, I would also never watch, I've never seen Django Unchained because I personally don't want to see that shit that leads up to him being the hero. I don't find that entertaining. I personally don't. Some people do. I don't. That's just me, though. You know? It's like people that thought that John Cena going out in on the award show naked. Oh, that was so fun. It's like it's humiliation. But a lot of people in this world are sick. So I can see why people would like that. Because they're depressed and they want to see other people go through it. Now, luckily for me, I haven't had Netflix for probably almost 5 or 6 years. I did all the shows beforehand, so I went through all of Castle, all of The Mentalist, Longmire, what else? It was a bunch of them. I did White Collar, but I don't think that's on Netflix anymore. Like Archer, I was doing so much, but now then it's turned all to exclusives, and then it turned to all like private side. Like everything is like devil bullshit. So I'm just sick. I'm sick of the shit that's like all no, we have to put devils in it. Where's the stuff for God? Oh, we don't do that anymore. We can't do that. That'd be offensive to people. Hollywood. We can't do that. So yeah, I'm so sick of Netflix because it's literally 90% of the shit's all like, we have to have devils in it.
Oh, thank God.
Yeah.
I thought I was gonna have
it's like, okay, I get it. I get it. I understand what you're saying. Ha ha ha, you sell your soul, I get it. I don't give a fuck.
What?
Yeah, that's gonna be a 2-person job.
Yeah, crime has some stuff, but it also the video isn't good. Like, I'm the first one to admit that. A lot of the shows now have like season one to like it'll be say 22 seasons of a show, and they'll have like three seasons. The rest of them they do not have the video for. So a lot of the stuff you have, like I've had to actually go and do Acorn TV and stuff, because a lot of the stuff with Prime, they just stop. They do no longer continue the contract, unfortunately. And now you don't even get, they used to have a 12 days remaining, 5 days remaining, even to the hour. Now they don't have shit, it's just like no longer available. Like half the movies I used to watch on Prime are all gone, and or it's buy or rent now. There's a lot of microtransactions. I'm like, I'm not doing that. I don't need to watch movies. I don't watch movies. Like I hardly watch any movies because most of them are political and or divorcing. Like that's it. Or Marvel Comics, let's blow shit up, destruction porn, which just like it's fucking mind-numbing bullshit. I get it, society needs that because they're lazy, but for me it's like Glass Onion. Give me stuff like Usual Suspect, Glass Onion, The Thomas Crown Affair, The Usual Suspects, The Game with Michael Douglas, Now You See Me. Stuff that makes you think. And I know people are like, oh, I want to think when I'm watching TV. That's the problem. That's the problem.
She was cool with it.
Wait, moving on.
Rear Window? I've never heard of that. I also, I think I watched one or two episodes of Black Mirror, and I'm like, yeah, I don't need that shit either. Oh, also I watched, it wasn't Pixel, it was, how's it called?
Well, I think I speak for everyone when I say that.
The one where they upload. I watched Upload. That was pretty cool. That was trippy as hell. Awesome.
Sure, there's nothing we can say to make you stay.
See, I don't watch the old Alfred Hitchcock movies. I don't rewatch any horror or movies unless it's very comedic. So I've seen tons of horrors, but I like the ones that everyone hated. Like, I like Open House, where you never actually saw the killer, and the killer got everyone's like, that's horrible. It's like, no, that's reality. The bullshit is when you have a god like six axe murderers going around and three people get to kill them all. That would never happen. I'm sorry. The bad guy usually wins. Welcome to reality.
Maybe she has gambling debts and she had to take time off to do favors for the mob boss.
Or like the old Psycho movie. Those were good too. The Norman
days. Hello.
Thank you.
We'll be right back.
All right, we're going to do a couple of more sets with the preacher, and then we're going to shut her down. It is Flex Friday. I will be back this week. I will be back Saturday and Sunday. Possibly not training, just like sit-ups, maybe some stretches, maybe gaming. It's going to be raining all weekend, apparently, so we're going to be inside doing stuff. So any questions, comments, concerns, please let me know. Hit me up on my YouTube channel. Hit that like button. Hit that sub button. Tell all your friends. Hit that daily dinger because we do this on the daily. Also, hit me up on X. I post MS4 a lot. The link to this channel. That is it. Marketing done. Well done, TJ. Thank you. All right. That is it for today. Flex Friday. I appreciate all the likes, the follows, the comments. You keep it on your end. I will keep it on my end. Beautiful relationship. None of the social media drama. I do not do TikTok. I do not do OnlyFans. I don't do any of the self-esteem apps. Don't need it because I got it. I check out my YouTube channel. Link is in the bio. Hit that like button. Hit that sub button. Tell all your friends. I'm also on X. I post 10 minutes before I go live to this channel. I also do shorts sometimes. So any questions, comments, concerns, let me know. Till tomorrow. Lift heavy. Lift strong. Most of all, lift. And be safe. Happy Flex Friday, people.